here for the tripartite, if I'm pronouncing that correctly.
Tripartite?
Thank you for correcting me. Meeting at 3 o'clock in the offices here today.
Okay. You are quite early.
I was wondering if you can show me where your public notice is for this meeting.
Yes.
And your agenda.
Come back here and I'll show you what we have.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Oh, come on back through the double doors. Right here?
Oh, perfect. Okay. Thank you very much.
How are you doing? Did Melissa call you?
She did.
Okay. I think we are here to say hi.
We can go to either one.
Whichever one?
Either conference room.
615, that's the other for me?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's
go to mine if you want.
Okay.
The last one, right?
How are you doing?
Good.
Ooh, fancy mancy. Good.
Senior.
I know. Nah. Whatever. Frenzy. The jail called. I had to take care of a matter for them.
What you gotta do?
Yeah. You about that?
I want you to drink.
I'm good. Thanks.
Thank you.
I saw Buddy today, so he said to tell you how.
Oh, how's he doing?
He was a little frantic. He was like underneath a stack of bills.
Oh, gosh. Poor thing. He is, you miss Buddy. He's the, newly appointed director for Cherokee County. So he came and sat in.
Last month.
Last month, yeah.
Yeah.
Just to observe, so. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm going to call this meeting to order. See that we do have a quorum here today. Okay, everyone present. If everyone will please read the agenda, if there's any additions I would like to make for the agenda. And if you need to add anything for executive session, we can do that after we move into executive session because there are some items we need to address. So, seeing there's no items to add to the agenda, I'd like to entertain a motion for someone for to accept the agenda as written.
So move.
Second.
Moving on to the agenda, we will move into the adoption of the minutes from our March 29th meeting. They're listed under your minutes tab there. If you're letting me know when everyone's had a chance to review them. Thank you. I'm sorry, I don't think we voted on the agenda. I got a motion and a second. All in favor of the agenda as written?
Aye.
Okay, any amendments or changes to the minutes of the meeting? Seeing none, I'd like to entertain a motion and a second to approve the minutes as written.
So moved.
Second.
For Daisy. All in favor, since Phil's here?
Aye.
Okay. I could get your signature on those, please, Miss Daisy. Next thing on the agenda is old business. There was no old business, so move into new business, which is the review of our current budget matters. We move into the tab under new business. The first thing that we'll be reviewing is our monthly budget for Indigent Defense. And we are doing awesome. We're only in March now, though, but yeah. We have 76% of the year remaining. And our total budget right now, we're at 81%. We're still about 4% off, but that also includes salaries and things I don't have any control over. But our operating expenses, which are on the second page that we always look at, which are the attorney fees, which are the most thing that we're looking at and all that. But operating expenditures, we're doing really good. We're at 82% actually on the expenditures. So I have had some expenses that just due to wear and tear on some office equipment. The county's upgrading to Windows 7 for all of our stuff. And I've had some printers that are 10 plus years old that were not that would not operate with Windows 7.
We're looking
to do that as well. So what we did instead of me purchasing new computers is we set up my Xerox copier. And we're using that as a copy printer, scanner, and everything. So I didn't have to do that. But there still were some expenses that was associated having to set up a network for that and everything. So, but the county's trying to go to utilizing our copiers for printers and scanners. It's just cheaper than having to each individual one buying stuff. So it is. It's so much cheaper on the, like, unbelievable. But the toner cartridges and stuff for those the big copiers are more economical than buying the little ones. So But other than that, still just seeing the same, pretty slow right now on the invoices, but again, it's the first of the year, and we always see trends like during the summertime and then during the holidays for the attorney invoices and stuff. So, but of that, we are still remaining in budget, which is great. The next thing that we're looking at is the attorney restitution checks that are paid through the probation offices. Georgia Probation Management, who handles our misdemeanor probation cases and even the misdemeanor cases out of felony court. We got a check from them for $2,053, which is a really good restitution for 1 month. And then the following two checks are copies from the Department of Corrections, which are strictly the felony cases. Mm-hmm. One check's $42, one check's $71. Those actually come from the state itself, so they come in, trickle in slowly throughout, so. And then the next thing under the new business is actually our case counts for the year to date for Indigent Defense. We've talked, and I don't know if I've explained, if I've told y'all this or not, but I know every month I meet with Dave Bruin, our chief financial officer for the county, who I directly report to for the county, and we go over our case count numbers, and he compares our numbers to the number of arrests, the number of cases the prosecutors are setting up, and I think I talked to the criminal defense bar, several members, and how our numbers were down last year. They were trending down. Even the jail population had trended down, and I think Sheriff Piper had even mentioned that the year budgets were significantly less last year for housing out inmates as they had been for the previous years. If you'll notice looking at our case counts for March, for February we were down 20% numbers from January, but in March we were back up 20%.
Okay.
So things are trending up. I think that's me
Things are trending up again, so, and again, we have no rhyme or reason for that. As again, the county is looking at that because they're trying to compare things for, you know, just with us growing a new jail, a new justice, a new courthouse and stuff. So we're just trying to see where the trends are, you know, to make sure we'll be building everything out the size that needs to be built out. So, right. But again, as you can see, we're 20 plus for March numbers just for Indigent Defense, and we work for February. So, yeah. So, yeah. Any questions about anything in the new business that we've gone over, or our case counts, or how we actually derived these? Park, I don't know if I explained this to you since you've rotated onto the committee, but our new Odyssey, our judicial software, enables me and all the other judicial departments to run numbers.
Right.
Run a lot of reports that we never had access to run before, or the ability to run before. So it's real easy to set up reports. We can run reports pretty much for anything we want, which is awesome. And so I set up this, I got some help setting up the spreadsheet. So it's real, given a lot of valuable information for me as a tool to run my budgets and stuff. So
it's like the increases all felonies too.
I noticed that. Yeah. So, and like I said, the second column there is probably what y'all want to, I use the first, the long column, that's just for my internal stuff, knowing how many people's not reporting as they're supposed to, and showing up, you know, things of that nature. But yeah, the case counts, felonies, misdemeanors, or yeah, like I said, probation, felony probations, we're seeing those have been trending high for a while. Mm-hmm. But the state imposed new policies and procedures for supervising of probationers.
Right.
So that's really impacted how they're, you know, they're doing those. Mm-hmm. So, and y'all have seen the new bond schedules.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So we're not sure how that's going to impact numbers either. If people are going to be bonding, not going to be bonding due to the new bond schedules and the new bond requirements that judge, the Superior Court judges have imposed. So we'll be interested on those. So.
Sure.
Okay. Any other thing to discuss in the new business that we've gone over? Okay. At this time, we do need to move into executive session to discuss some attorney-client privileged information. And we'll like to entertain a motion to move into executive session.
Question.
Second. Parker. Okay. And we will come get you when we move out of executive session.
Thank you very much.
Motion and a second to move out of executive session. I need a motion and a second to move back into the regular meeting.
So moved.
Phill, I have a motion to hear a second to move back into the regular meeting.
Second.
Second by Parker. Okay. We've concluded, all in favor of moving back into the regular meeting, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. We're back into the regular meeting now. We've concluded all of the items on the agenda for voting purposes only. Is there any other informational items that the committee would like to discuss or anything in a regular session?
Is that a question of your software?
Yes.
With the county, will it track seasonally also that you're just, I know in economics you'll adjust for seasonal averages. Is that something that's a capability or is that important? Is there any other time of year that's more active than others?
Well, as far as seasonal, I think our monthly reports will be picking up on that because, you know, we'll just be able to pull, yeah. We'll be, definitely be able to pull it. I don't know what you mean by, you know, seasonal, but monthly we will be able to
you
pull all that.
More activity at Christmas than you do in
I think the warm weather is bringing people out. They've been hibernating all year, all, you know, winter time, and with us having the lake and stuff, that really impacts it because temperatures go up, the lake opens up, and, you know, have a lot
you
more.
I think you would be able to predict or find some standard deviation with that over course of time. Shouldn't be that hard to determine.
Comparing the numbers from 2010 through so far 2013, they've been pretty sporadic. Yeah, not unfortunate, but we, you know, we don't know. We're waiting just to see. You know, it may impact, you know, the new sheriff being, you know, in office. Don't know. We're curious too. We, you know, really are. I'm really curious about the numbers. You know, to see what's going on. Luckily, knock on wood,
We've not had any, we haven't had a murder case since the Ingalls murder, which was a couple years ago. We went through a phase there where we had a lot of ag assaults, you know, some really high profile cases. We had the Milano's burglary case, which it was burglary, but it was multi-million dollars, you know, so hopefully our trends for major cases are going to go down. But yeah, the misdemeanors always rise in the summertime. New DUI law that's going into effect for boating and stuff. Mm-hmm. We'll see how that impacts things because nobody ever knows what the new laws are. And, you know, so especially in boating, a lot of boaters don't anticipate that they have the same requirements as, you know, any other motorized vehicles. So.
Will the Juvenile Justice Act affect you or help you? Or?
Well, since my office only deals in the criminal portion of the juvenile cases, we don't deal with the terminations and deprivation matters anymore. I don't know. We have a duty attorney that's there that handles a lot of our criminal matters, delinquencies, and truancy matters. So, I don't know, we'll see.
I wonder if you'd have an unintended consequence that you'd get those marked up to adults.
I don't know. Yeah. I haven't even had a chance to even review the whole, it's still, the whole juvenile law is still a little, I haven't been able to read it, and to me, what I have read is still a little vague to me. You know, I haven't seen any. I don't know what Judge Jackson, you know, juvenile court, you know, had him sit down and have a talk with him about it or anything. But just to let you know, too, Judge Bagley's called a meeting of the mental health task force for next week. I know that they are possibly looking at, you know, the creation of a mental health court as we do in another alternative court. Again, that's still up in the air, but we have had an active mental health task force. We've just been on hiatus until, you know, but I know that was part of some of the legislature was looking at some of the alternative courts and stuff too, so yeah. So we'll be able to see that. If y'all noticed, the courthouse will be is moving along. According to the paper, according to the last meeting they had last week, I think, they'll move forward in July, I believe, with the groundbreaking. So, you know, with all the permits and, you know, all that, they've been done. Everybody's been asking me what's going on. They tore it down, now they've stopped. Well, now we're just, you know, they've got to actually get all the permits together, look at all the groundwork and get started on that, which will probably hopefully be in July. So I know I've been meeting with architects and the interior decorators for the remodeling of the existing courthouse, you know, for my office space that'll be moving into the existing courthouse. So, should have plenty of space. Probate, magistrate, indigent defense, pretrial services, and all the alternative courts, DUI drug court, will be in the existing courthouse when it gets remodeled, when everybody moves into the new courthouse. So, the county will be utilizing every inch of every available building. So, yeah, and they're still saying 18 months. You know, 18 months to 2 years.
We'll see.
So, okay. All right. Any other discussions or anything? Okay. About the entertaining motion that we adjourn the meeting?
So moved.
Okay. Parker, second by Phil. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. All right. That concludes our meeting then.
Thank you.
I will let y'all know the next meeting, get with y'all on your schedules and, okay. See if we can, you know, get the next one done. So we'll move down to your office one day. So yeah, Daisy's down there now.
Yeah.
So
feel good.
Where are you now?
Midway.
Right.
Yeah. Behind the Kroger there.
Okay.
Good. The Kroger manual. Oh, okay. I'm where that's at.
Yeah,
okay.
Okay. Thanks,
guys.
Yeah,
thank you.
You have a good trip.
Thank you. Sure. Appreciate it.